In this video, ladies, I'm going to share with you how I permanently fixed my thinning eyebrows with hair transplant for eyebrows. Look at that picture of me at age of 19, how I butchered my eyebrows with tweezing. I got them so thin, it's like a line. And I didn't stop there. I continued waxing them, lasering them, electrolysis. Eventually, thankfully, I wised up and I stopped, but my eyebrows never grew back to the fullness I had when I was a teenager. Look at how my eyebrows looked at the age of 37, right before the hair transplant. Next month is gonna be 5 years ago. Notice on top of my eyebrows, I lacked fullness. Also, the eyebrows were starting to be too far apart and they were uneven. I was spending so much time filling them in with makeup and I did not like the results because they did not look natural. I started to look at options that were permanent to fix my thinning eyebrows. I didn't like the idea of getting them tattooed and microbladed because those were not 100% natural, and looking natural is very important to me. I don't mind having work done on myself. I don't mind sharing with the world the work I have done on myself, but I want those things to look natural. The only solution I found was hair transplant on my eyebrows, because that's using my own hair from the back of my head. The solution was permanent. There weren't that many risks other than an infection. And as long as I chose a good doctor, I minimized my risk of infection considerably. And the cost of the procedure was fairly reasonable. It cost me $2,000. Day of my appointment, I had to wake up super early and I am not a morning person. Hair transplant, even on a small area such as the eyebrows, is still very tedious and takes several hours. My transplant took about 5 hours. Before the actual procedure started, the technician meticulously measured and drew my eyebrows to the 0.5 millimeter to make sure that you're gonna get the shape and the fullness for the eyebrows the way I wanted it. Afterwards, I took a Valium, I believe, and a pain pill, and I went to La La Land. While I was still fairly coherent, I remember the two technicians parted my hair in two and braided that, I believe. Things did get fuzzy pretty quickly, but then they shaved one area right here and one area right here. Those were the donor sites for my eyebrows. In the procedure room, I do not remember much. I know first they numbed my eyebrows and my scalp, and I was nervous. The only thing I felt though was one tiny prick right there. The other thing I remember, at some point, I was laying on my stomach. The Neograph machine was pulling hair out of my scalp, and I know it sounds awful, but as I was laying on my stomach, I was laughing and I was telling the nurse, "I know you're pulling hair out of my head, but I don't feel anything." This is how I looked when I got home from the doctor's office. I had a lot of swelling on my eyes and I had to keep my head wrapped because I had to keep pressure on the donor sites on the back of my head. I had no pain, no discomfort. I felt really good. The only annoying thing, I was not allowed to do anything. All I could do is lay like this on the couch the whole day. I asked the doctor if at the very least I could do laundry. They said no, because if I put forth any physical effort, I could pop out the hair that was just transplanted on my eyebrows. So I had to rest. This is how I looked the day after the procedure. The swelling went down a lot. If it wasn't for the head wrap, I looked fairly normal. Look at that belly. He's got such a cute belly. I had to keep the wrap around my head for 3 days And it worked out really nicely for me. I had the procedure done on Friday and I removed the wrap on Monday morning. On Monday morning, most of the swelling was gone, but I started to get bruising around my eyes. But if I kept my eyes open, the bruising was not as noticeable. I do want to say that when I went in for my checkup, and I believe I went in on Monday morning, the technician was very surprised at the little swelling and bruising I had. They said to me that I was a good case scenario for healing. They expected me to come in with fairly swollen eyes and a lot more bruising. So far, the recovery and the procedure have been easy. But pay attention to my right eyebrow, and I don't know if the difference is so small, I'm the only one who notices it, but it is there. So pay attention to my right eyebrow. Notice how it has just a nice fullness all across. Then pay attention to my left eyebrow. The left one right here is not quite as full. When the eyebrows start healing from the hair transplant, they are going to start to itch. And based on my experience, the itching is the only drawback during the whole procedure and recovery. The itching lasts about 7 to 10 days and you are not allowed to touch the eyebrows. But me, I thought I was so smart. One evening, I thought I can kind of like, maybe just do kind of this on my eyebrows to kind of scratch them. And I pulled a few of the hairs out from right here. I was hoping they're gonna grow back, but they did not grow back. There are two things that make eyebrows that had hair transplant done on them different than the natural untouched eyebrow. One, the hair that has been transplanted on the eyebrows, because it came from the back of our head, that hair grows at the same rate as the hair on our head, which is faster than the typical eyebrow hair. So I have to trim my eyebrows more often than I used to do before I had the transplant. I think I trim my eyebrows about once a week. The second thing that makes my eyebrows different now, the hair that has been transplanted, because again, it came from the back of my head, it is thicker than the eyebrow hair. I have never thought of that, but it is thicker and just a bit coarser. Also, the hair that has been transplanted doesn't lay as flat. The hair that is natural from the eyebrows just grows very flat against the skin. The hair that has been transplanted grows just a bit more up. The way I learned, and I learned that other people that had transplant done control that, is to keep the eyebrows trimmed shorter than normal. Hair transplant on my eyebrows is the easiest procedure I ever had. Do you want to know which one is by far the toughest? And I'm not exaggerating. That's the CO2 laser. The results are amazing, but it is a freaking tough procedure and I had it done 3 times. Of course, I have a YouTube video on that. So ladies, I'll see you in the next video.